The one not time notification is out here and you don't know how to use it. Let me show you behind the scenes over my shoulder how to set up a one-time notification message to send inside your flow. I'm gonna show you how to do so. Stay tuned for the next video.
Hey, my name is Ana Andrea, and in this channel you will be learning about chat marketing, customer service tips and tricks, neuromarketing, and more techie tutorials of my favorite tools. Enjoy the next video.
Okay, so we're here inside ManyChat, and we're going to first go to our flows, and we're going to create a flow. To create a new flow, you just go here to the top left button that says new flow. Okay, so one time notification flow. Okay, so we can add this one-time notification message in any of our messages inside all of our flows. That's fine. I'm just creating a new one just for this example, but you can add this one-time notification to for people to get notified about anything you want in any flow, okay? I'm just going to illustrate this way. Okay, so we're here on send message. We're going to click here, and if you see, it doesn't, don't select any content type because this is just your normal flow. So let's say that you're a coach and you want to use the bot to generate leads, and you are going to have a Facebook Live or a YouTube video that's going to go out, and you want people to get notified about it. All right, we're going to keep it simple. So you're going to have a YouTube video that's going to go out, and you want to notify your leads. So you have it on the flow. So you tell, you say, some people actually are, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to tell people that you're going to send them a link. Okay, we're going to create a growth tool, a ref URL. That's a another video, another tutorial. You're going to create a growth tool, a ref URL. You're going to connect this message, okay? And you're going to send it to people, and people are going to subscribe inside the bot. So tell them that they have to subscribe inside to receive notifications for that Facebook Live that you're going to give about X subject. Let's say you're going to go live on a specific date, and you already know, okay? So we go here, and we go to the send, enter your text. So we're gonna say, hey, we're gonna add the first name so it's personalized and people feel like they're talking to them. This is how people feel rapport through chats that are automated, okay? So we go to, hey, first name. We are happy you want to learn more. A lot of typos there, so I want to learn more. We are going live with X topic, right? Whatever topic you want to put here, right? I don't know, just giving you a little bit of copy advice inside messages, because messages are not the same as emails. We cannot write them the same. You gotta chat with people, all right? So, and short is better. Short, sweet, and concise. So SSC, okay? We gotta do that. Short, sweet, and concise. Okay, so we are happy you want to learn more. We're going to go live with X topic on, let's say, March 30th at 12 p.m. Eastern. 12 p.m. Eastern. And then we're going to add some emojis. I have a plugin that I use called Joy Pixels to get all the emojis in the world. So let's see. We're going to use this one, just because. Oh no, wait, here. Mm-hmm. This is taking forever. Okay, I'm just gonna use ones from here inside ManyChat. They don't have a lot of options, but we're just gonna use a smiley face or something. Okay, we're gonna use this one. And then we're gonna use, you can, here, this is the, where you select the one-time notification message. You can have that as the starting message, it's fine. But I personally always like to introduce everything I'm going to tell people and be a little bit more explanatory and tell them what's gonna happen. Because people want to know, and you gotta tell them what they have to do as well. So here it says get notified, and it says this text is added by Facebook Messenger when you OTNR is shown to a subscriber. Okay, so this is already pre-written for you. Okay, so we go here and we click. We gotta enter a topic name, so we get a token. We gotta get one token. Remember on the video, I'm going to link the video up here when I talk about all about OTN, which is the one-time notification request. I'm going to link it up here so you can know about why we had to write this topic. So this is the token, and you got to select a token. You can create any topic name, or I select from the ones you already created. So in this case, I'm going to say live interactive chatbot masterclass, right? So I got it right here, or I can create a new one. Let's say in this case, it's going to be a, let's say Facebook Live. No, and I'm actually going to say, yeah, Facebook Live is fine. Okay, and it says, new topic. So either you can click here or you could just click enter on your keyboard. And there you go. Topic created. And it says select or create a topic that matches your request. Same topics should be used in the follow-up message notification itself to pair it with the current request. And I'm going to explain to you how we're going to select the topic when we send this message. Okay, so stay tuned. This is a complete tutorial. And I'm gonna open this new tab for the more details so I can link this link, obviously. I can link this link. Ugh, gosh, we need more words in the English dictionary. So I can put on the description below this information so you can learn more about it yourself, okay? So we're gonna describe the topic of the follow-up. Oh, and we're gonna click on done. We gotta click on the green button that says done. And now we have 65 characters, only 65 characters to describe the topic. So let's describe it. It says, I personally, this is advice from using bots since 2016 and being a, well, since they got out, not 2016, actually, that's a lie. Sorry. I'm very bad with dates. You're going to notice that about me. I'm really bad with dates. So bots, I started using them around 2017 at the end. And in 2018, I became a ManyChat partner. So what does that mean? That means that I've been using ManyChat for a long time. And I know a lot how people react to it, how they respond, what works, what doesn't work. It's really good. It's a very good experience, and I'm going to be creating more videos about this. So please subscribe to this video with the notification bell so you get a notification every time I post videos on my YouTube channel. Okay, so just subscribe here. And if you're watching on another platform, just subscribe wherever you're watching. Okay, I'm reusing the videos. Everybody does that. Anyways, so forgive me, YouTuber, YouTube fans. But it's the truth. Okay, so get notified. I'm going to describe the topic below. Why I said all this is because we need to tell people what to do. And if they don't know how to use the chatbot, which is normally the case, you're gonna they're gonna not know what to do. So you gotta tell them to click on that notify me button always. So try to use only 65 characters. This is tricky, so make sure you think of this through. So let's say click notify me button to get the message when we go live. And then I would add emojis that are hands or arrows that point to the button, okay? Be very visual because it's chat. People use emojis, they talk with emojis. Like, just think about how you chat with your friends, okay? Just think about how you chat with your friends. Is it impersonal? No, right? It's very personal because you're chatting with a friend. So same, think about your leads as your friends. So not, I'm not saying they all are your friends and blah, 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 blah. I know they're not, but if you feel like love for your leads, you want them to succeed and that you're my kind of people, basically, because I am here to help you succeed. So there you go. Oh, and it's telling me that I have too many characters, and I clicked on it and it disappeared. So we're going to click on it again. So it appears again. There we go. Okay. So it says negative 13 characters. So let's see why it has negative 13 characters. Negative 3, it says. Okay. So we're going to remove one of the other emojis. Okay. Now I have enough space. Okay. So I can only put one hand. Maybe I can put another one and see. Yes. No, it goes to negative 2 when I do that. Do you see what happens here in the little? I'm going to blow it up so you can see. Because it's hard. Okay. Yeah. I should just blown it up. Okay. You see? Okay, wait, here. You see that number 3? If I put more, another emoji, whatever emoji it is, it goes to negative 2. So that's strange. So it's not even 65 characters. It's less than 65 characters. Why? Because when they send the message, Facebook, it has another message there too as well. So they don't want to make it like super huge. Okay. So that's why they limit you on the characters in the OTNR. So that's it. We're going to click on done here and we're going to publish. Content published. All right. So that's it. You can add other stuff. You can make the whole bot flow and you can add another OTNR in the middle of it. Like, do whatever you need to do to communicate with your leads and get them on board on everything that you do and get consent from them and clear your list of people who do not consent. All right. That's my best advice on this. Okay. And bam. That is it. That is how you use the one-time notification on ManyChat. That's how you set it up on your flows. And that's it. I will see you guys in the next episode with another topic to help you become irresistible online so that your leads become your raving fans. I will see you in the next one. Remember to subscribe, like this video, share it, follow me on Instagram at Irresistible Latina. Also, check out my other videos for more information and more topics on anything that has to do with techie stuff and marketing. I'll see you guys later on the next one. Bye-bye!